FIFO Image QType is fundamentally a signal recorder. This takes the basic signal recorder tool within the shape editor and turns it into a full-fledged QType. While FIFO images can be interacted with using your mouse, the general idea is to utilize them with the external input options under the green waveform boxes. Here you could select any sort of input, MIDI, DMX, and really whatever you can imagine. The Q has the normal new, open, and save functions, image properties, view options, object identifier, quick capture, pause, and restart options in the top bar, as well as show it now, zone selection, and the blackout button. On the right, we have three menus, the FIFO settings, its morphing effects, and its final effect. Under settings, we have a number of options related to the image settings. First, under FIFO, we have the point count total the image will max out at. Next, the record interval. This is how many milliseconds before it will record another point. Then we have the breakup. This will determine at what distance between inputs will be blanked versus connected. A value of 1 will always split up the data, while a value of 100 will always connect the data. This can be useful for jumps that in real life may be like lifting of the pen on a touch input system. Lastly, you also have just a beam mode. This will place a beam on each sample. Below the FIFO options, you have the FIFO transform matrix. These are basically transformations for movement over these axes from a sample age perspective. So if we move the position Y value up to 50, as we draw, the lines from the samples we placed will move upward at a speed. All these values for size, angle, and position work this way from here. Note, all these values can be modified with external inputs as you would expect, and it's likely that will be the more common use for these functions. Below that, you have the cursor position. This will be where the position of your samples will be. This will move with your mouse on the left, but these are designed to be used with external inputs like the rest. Now, let's change from the Settings tab to the Morphing Effect tab. Similarly to the movement options in the Settings tab, Morphing Effects will apply the placed effects onto your points based on their age, with the acceleration selected, as its guide on how much to apply the effect. You are able to use the entire effects engine here and apply progressively on the alpha of the effect on the age of the data. Then, with final effect, this is the traditional effect application where you apply it to all points as they are seen in the image at that time. The order of all these are based in the order of the list: settings, morphing, then final effect. In our example queue, you can build a symmetrical live abstract kind of effect like so, utilizing cloning effects, color effects, and morphing effects, like you see here. Thanks for watching this quick hints video on the new FIFO image editor in Beyond 5.5. If you still have questions or need help, feel free to contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com or reading the written documentation of this queue type on the wiki at wiki.pangolin.com.